Ladies and gentlemen, this is the second match in the running of the gauntlet. Introducing first, the blocker. He weighs in at 241 pounds from Charlotte, North Carolina. On six different occasions, he's been the world heavyweight champion. Ladies and gentlemen, the Nature Boy,
a big money match. Where is Scott Steiner? First time ever one-on-one on national television. We're very proud to have it right here on World Championship Wrestling. We'll be joined in a few moments, ladies and gentlemen, by Thunderbolt Patterson, who'll be here to watch this match with Bob Cottle tonight. But right now, let's go back up to Tony Gillum and the introduction of the runner of the gauntlet.
Ladies and gentlemen, his opponent, the runner of this week's gauntlet, in the second match, he's from Detroit, Michigan, at 269 pounds, one half of the U.S. Tag Team Champions, Scott Steiner!
Indeed, it may be hammer time, as Big Brother Rick leads his little brother Scott to the ring.
Well, I was going to say, Jim, I'm glad to see that he brought his second with him, because Arn Anderson there with Nature Boy Ric Flair, and you got to keep the eyes on the horseman at all times. Got very wise to have Rick come out to the ring with him.
Ladies and gentlemen, of course, the big event in the Omni is tomorrow night at 7:30 in the Omni. Our good friend Thunderbolt Patterson has joined us. His headline, the biggest cards in the history of the Omni. And Bolt, I understand you'll be there tomorrow night as the Steiners defend the U.S. tag titles against the SST.
That's right. You know, in the past, I've been trying to be around, and I got the opportunity to be in the corner with the Steiners tomorrow night. And I'm thankful for the opportunity to here tonight to sit and watch one of the Steiners go against Ric Flair, which was the world champion for five or six times.
Six-time
world champion, one of the greatest one-on-one matches I think that we'll ever see on television.
The Nature Boy starting out at his pace, a very deliberate pace, because Scott Steiner may be a little overzealous here, Bolt. He's in there with a living legend in wrestling. And I know a lot of guys say, well, I'm a legend, but this man indeed has earned it. Nice fireman carry takeover.
This is what it's all about, professional wrestling. And Steiner, when he get into that ring, he knows how to wrestle.
Steiner holding on very pugnaciously with that arm bar.
As Thunderbolt said, not only does he know how to wrestle, but Steiner is such a well-built youngster. He's such a powerful young man, too, all that ability that he's got.
That's right. He has what it takes to become not only in a tag match, but you can see how he carries himself on a one-on-one.
A lot of fans, very knowledgeable fans, say this young man has world championship material written all over him. Well, this is the measuring stick. I would say that they would be measured by the Nature Boy. And there's a power move off the ropes. Scott Steiner with a lot of power, nailing Nature Boy Ric Flair. I asked Flair last night, Bob, on the Power Hour, if he was going to try to mat wrestle Scott Steiner and try to negate some of that great strength advantage that Steiner has. He said, I'll know how to wrestle him when I look into his eyes when we step into the ring.
Well, I think that's true, but I think you would be wise to do that. And Jim, I started to say also, six times world champion. Here's a man that's been up against the very best that the sport has had to offer for some time. He's been in against them all. That's experience that you can only get from in the ring. And that's one thing that Scott Steiner at the moment, even though he's got a lot of experience, he doesn't have the caliber of experience as does Ric Flair.
Well, Scott has such a great young background, and he's coming up real good in this professional, and it looks like that he has all the ability in the world to become not only as a tag champion, but in a single. So he knows how to wrestle, he knows how to fight, he's in good condition. Just keep watching him.
He's got all the tools, no doubt about it. As he shoots Flair off to the ropes, this time Flair puts Steiner on his back. Nice football tackle by the Nature Boy. Leapfrog by Scott Steiner. He's got Flair up. He's got him up. What's he gonna do with him? Tilt a whirl slam. Scott Steiner slamming Nature Boy Ric Flair, going for the pin here. One, two, leg grapevine. But Flair gets out and rolls out of bounds. Scott Steiner's got him. Here he is. There's a Steiner line. Scott Steiner just nailed Ric Flair, and we'll take a break on that move, and we'll be right back. the corner. Again goes out of bounds. That'll break the momentum that was being mounted by Scott Steiner. Boy, the fans here, this one, you could cut the anticipation with a knife in this one.
They're really behind that Steiner, aren't they?
They certainly are, Bolt.
Well, and I think Flair, the blows that Scott Steiner has landed have had a little more telling effect on Ric Flair. He seems to be the more tired of the two at the moment.
And Bob, that may be a little bit of subterfuge because Flair is a long way from running out of gas.
You never can count him out.
Another test of strength. Again, Flair. So, great strategy and what a chop. He flaps Scott's
nice
chip up.
Nice nip up.
Steiner with the right hand, but Flair controlling the action. Sends him for the ride. There's a Steiner line. He pulverized Flair. Here's Rick Steiner with a right hand on the nature ball. Rick Steiner must be very careful not to get his partner disqualified.
Right.
So if Flair wins it by disqualification, the running of the gauntlet has ended.
Well, you know, but Rick wouldn't be out there if Arn wasn't there.
Keep your eye on Rick Steiner over there. He's sizing up the nature boy. There's the enforcer to step in.
Rick can hardly resist it, Jim. He wants to get into the action so bad.
Right. Rick would never be there if Arn wasn't there, so that's kind of evening it up there a little bit.
You got to fight fire with fire with the horseman. And now Flair, well, he's got Steiner out. Steiner
pops
the rail. There's the power.
He got the power.
But Flair was nailed. Head first into the railing. Right hand by Scott Steiner. Shoulder first into the post. Scott Steiner, high impact with a nature ball and a Steiner line.
This young man have everything that it takes.
Flair's got to be reeling from that beating. Got to be.
But never count him out.
He keeps coming back.
Never can count him out.
Ric Flair, the number three contender for the heavyweight championship of the world, behind Lex Luger and behind Big Sid Vicious at number two. The Horsemen occupy four places in the top ten.
That's right. Flair held the championship longer than anyone in...
Flair the right hand. He is a master now.
Ooh, dangerous.
Was so solid there in the chest of Scott Steiner. A nice...
But look at the adrenaline.
The momentum now is in with Ric Flair, I gotta think. Flair's got the advantage.
He has it.
He can cut you in two with those chops, and it's a big equalizer as far as Flair is concerned.
And don't forget, Bob, he's got that figure four leg lock in both.
Sure.
You've been in the figure four before. It's one of the most excruciating holds in wrestling.
Yes, it is.
Scott Steiner fighting back.
He's got a lot of fight in him.
Oh, he's got a heart, doesn't he?
Oh.
Power slam. He's wrestling a power match with a nature ball. And the fans want to see the Frankensteiner. That's what he put Bobby Eaton away with last night. But right now, he sets Flair up on the top turnbuckle. He may suplex him off on the top rope. Ricky Steiner and Arn Anderson tried to interfere. Referee trying to... Wait a minute.
Oh.
From behind, Arn Anderson nailed him from behind. The referee was detained with Rick Steiner. Flair's got his feet on the ropes. One, two, and he couldn't hold him down.
He kicked out. He kicked out. That's power.
Arn Anderson, so what does it take to pin this guy? I'm sure they thought they had it.
Not only will this take great conditioning, which Scott Steiner has, Jim, but a lot of intestinal fortitude and the will that just will not quit.
That's right.
High elevation by Scott Steiner. There's the Steiner line. The momentum has turned again. It's in favor of the Steiner. Arn Anderson, held Flair. Scott Steiner was going for the Frankensteiner, but Arn Anderson held his comrade. referees and the referee almost two matches here.
Double team.
The DDT. Again, the horseman strike. Well, this should be all. Referee out there with Arn Anderson. But look at the standard on his top. Big Brother just nailed Flair. Big Brother nailed Flair. One, two, three.
One, two, three.
To fight for this
time. Our thanks to Thunderbolt Patterson. Scott Steiner takes on Arn Anderson tomorrow night for $15,000, Bob.
One more step.
And Jim, this requires great teamwork. Look at that Frankensteiner by Rick Steiner. As he came into the ring, Scott then, all he had to do was go over and cover Ric Flair for the count of three, as Scott Steiner has won the second leg of the gauntlet.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, it will be this Sunday night, tomorrow night, Arn Anderson, Scott Steiner for 15 grand. Here's the champ.
Yeah, Rusty, all I have to say now is my curiosity is up definitely. And I am obsessed one way or another. I'm going to find you, Mr. Black Scorpion.
Those comments from the champion of the world, and we'll be back. We'll talk to Sid Vicious and Arn Anderson right after this timeout.
Hi, I'm Missy Hyatt, inviting you to join Jim Ross and me tomorrow night at 6:05 for the NWA main event. You'll see Scott Steiner versus Arn Anderson for the finals of the Running of the Gauntlet. And that's tomorrow at 6:05 right here on TBS.
All right, Sid, I know you want Sting for the heavyweight championship of the world.
Sting, do you remember what happened to you in that clash, boy? You're running around here saying, I've got trouble with the Black Scorpion. Wrong, sucker. You got trouble with me, the baddest man in the NWA. I'm coming after your title.
And tomorrow night, right here on TBS, you stand between Scott Steiner and $15,000.
My friend, it is headhunting time. Scott Steiner, you have done the unmentionable. On Friday night, you stole one over Bobby Eaton. On Saturday night, somehow with the grace of God, you slipped over on Ric Flair. Now tomorrow, you gotta jump on the baddest count of them all. I'm taking no more prisoners. I'm not mollycoddling anybody. I'm looking at a dead man, Steiner. Right now.
Fans, we'll see you tomorrow night at 6:05.